Last week I made a short tilt shift video, I'll put a link in the description below, and I got a ton of requests asking me how I did it. No you didn't, bro. Literally one person maybe asked. Shut up, Dylan, no one freaking likes you. Tilt shift photography and videography is most commonly created by using a specific lens designed to give that look. Basically, the lens optics tilt and shift in relation to the camera's sensor, thus making magic. However, I do not own one of these lenses. So I made a poor man's tilt shift by using my editing software. Before I tell you the recipe to this witchcraft, if you have not subscribed to my channel, then make sure you click the red subscribe button when you can. So when you go out filming, it's ideal to find a spot that looks down on what you want to film. This will give the illusion that the viewer is a kid or an adult looking down on an oddly realistic toy set. What I did when I was filming was just keep my camera static and I zoomed in on specific areas for around 2 minutes each. The first test I did, I shot a photo time lapse and it really just didn't look as good as when I shot a video. The cars were just moving too fast for my liking. With video, I changed my shutter speed to 1/96th a second instead of my normal 1/50th a second, and I kept my frames at 24 frames a second. I was able to create some unnatural movement out of the cars, which I was really going for. So in the editing room, you'll upload your footage and then color grade. I figured since most toys and model sets are brightly colored that my shots should be, so I bumped up the saturation a little and made sure to expand my dynamic range as usual. To make the movement of whatever is in your shot more unnatural, speed up the clip. I sped most of my clips up anywhere from 200 to even 1000%. Just find what you think looks good. The main effect in Final Cut Pro you're gonna use is called focus. It's free and it can be a little tricky to kind of get down, but just play with it and you should be fine. The amount is how much of the effect is put on the clip, and this varied for me from shot to shot. Softness is basically how gradual you want to make this effect. I found that I rarely went over the default setting, which is around 578, but I definitely played around with it below that default setting. Emphasis is subtle, but basically it's like vignetting and highlighting your focus. The setting wasn't as important in my opinion, but I'd still mess around with it. With width, I had the slider almost always to 100. The times I lowered it, it was only a few points. Lastly is the height, and this is how horizontally tight the effect is. You'll play around with this one a lot. Basically, there's no set settings. My sliders were quite different most of the time. I just experimented with different options to find what I thought looked best. The other two effects I added were sharpen and cartoon eyes. I set my sharpen to 2.0 and I set cartoon eyes. Why does that sound so weird?
You're an idiot.
I set cartoon eyes to 28. Finally, I add some sound effects to finish off the video. I started out trying only high-pitched sound effects because I thought it would be funny and it would match well, but I actually ended up liking the normal sounds of cars and buses more for some reason. I did add some higher pitch honks to give it a nice finish touch. And that's about it, guys. You now have your free and simple recipe to creating your own miniature world. If you enjoyed this video and it helped you out, help me out by pressing the thumbs up button, and let me know if you have any suggestions on how I can make a better tilt shift video. Have an amazing day.